Josh Leivo. Very, very polarizing Vancouver Canuck player at the moment. Now, the Vancouver Canucks are playing a game later tonight against the Pittsburgh Penguins, where Josh Leivo will not be a part. And in fact, Josh Leivo will not be a part of the Vancouver Canucks lineup for 2 to 3 months with a fractured kneecap, says Travis Green. Now, if you didn't realize what happened, well, let's go over that a little bit here. It's Nick Holden who has a really, really big hit on Josh Leivo as Leivo is going around the boards trying to get the puck as it was rebounding all across. He gets pushed right into the boards and it looked like his right kneecap is the thing that pushes itself into the boards there. It has a very big collision. Holden is trying to dig away at the puck. Leivo is down and Leivo leaves the game in frustration. He slams his stick on the boards as he exits. Now we get the idea here. It's 2 to 3 months with a fractured kneecap and Nick Holden didn't get a penalty on the play. That was something that a lot of Canucks fans were really upset about, and understandably so. It was a really damaging looking hit, and Nick Holden was the guy who did it. In fact, Bo Horvat said in the intermission that the referee told Horvat that the referees all thought that Leivo had tripped, which is why he fell down. Okay, that's not a very good explanation for the minds of most Vancouver Canucks fans. But the ultimate decision here is 2 to 3 months. Leivo is not going to be on the Vancouver Canucks then. He will most likely go on the LTIR, and it's a shame. The guy was at 19 points in 36 games. He was playing legitimately like the best hockey of his career after getting sent over from the Toronto Maple Leafs. He legitimately was improving, and seeing things end up the way they have been very, 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 very unfortunate. However, because this is a video talking about that as well as what's going to happen next, I will set out this big disclaimer here. This was posted onto Twitter. This was posted onto Reddit. And I think it's something that I would like to preach here too. Just because Nick Holden did that does not mean that we as fans should go over to Nick Holden's Instagram and comment the meanest things imaginable in his comment section. Heck, I don't even know if he has an Instagram, but if he does, don't harass the guy. Don't do it. We saw this with so many players over the past, like, year and a half. Mike Matheson, last year, after the Elias Pettersson thing, yeah, he had that same thing. Danique Martel, after that really heated Tampa Bay game, had the same thing. Then we had, I believe Austin Zarnik had the same thing, as well as Jesperi Kotkaniemi when he got tangled up with Pettersson. Don't do this to Holden. The guy, although he did cause Leivo to get hurt, he doesn't in any shape or form deserve the foul-mouthed treatment that Vancouver Canucks fans are able to provide. It's immature, and overall, if you're doing that, if you have done that, please just exit the channel. I don't want you watching these videos. So, yeah, don't do that. But now that Leivo is out, and now that we have ourselves an open spot on the roster, things have changed up a little bit, because Loui Eriksson has found himself in the lineup here. He was playing in a line with Horvat and Pearson. So for now, it looks like Loui Eriksson is going to be here in the lineup, but one may ask, for the next 2 to 3 months, what's going to happen then? Who's going to get called up? Because I doubt we see Loui Eriksson in this lineup for 2 to 3 months without exploring the possibility of having another guy up. We have other players in the system. We have Goldobin. We have Reid Boucher. We have Sven Baertschi, who is looking to revitalize his NHL career. And any of these guys could be a potential suitor to that spot. Zach McEwen was called up to the Vancouver Canucks again, and that's just really, really funny. It's terrible for Zach McEwen because he's been going up and down and up and down and up and down and up and down over the past, like, 2 weeks, like crazy. people are getting injured, McEwen's getting called up, people are coming back into the lineup, McEwen's getting sent down. If you go to the Utica Comets Instagram page, which, yeah, let's do that right here. Instagram.com. Is it Utica Comets? Yeah, it is Utica Comets. Let's see the amount of Zach McEwen up and down posts they've posted in the last little bit. All right, here we go. Zach McEwen from the Comets to Vancouver yesterday. Then Zach McEwen from the Canucks to the Comets 6 days ago. Let's scroll down a little bit more. And all right, there's Jalen Chatfield. There's Michael DiPietro. There's David Pope. Here, Zach McEwen from the Comets to the Canucks, December 11. Michael DiPietro, Zach McEwen from the Canucks to the Comets on December 7. Then it's Antoine Roussel, etc., etc. Yeah, so McEwen has been going up and down. The Comets Instagram feed is flooded with Zach McEwen transfer posts. But now, McEwen is technically on this team, so he's a part of the lineup. We will be looking to see where he slots in eventually when that happens. But for now, it's Loui Eriksson with Horvat and Pearson. That's something that I don't necessarily see staying for the long term, so let's explore the options on the other players available. Nikolay Goldobin is a guy who is one of the best scorers in the AHL. In fact, yeah, no, Goldobin and Boucher are two of the top scorers in the AHL. Sven Baertschi is up there in terms of the points per game, but because he hasn't played as much as the other guys, he's not really there. But all three of these guys could be potential suitors. Now, Goldobin, going back to him, I think if he does get sent back up to the Vancouver Canucks, they should not try to fulfill him in that role that Loui Eriksson is traditionally in. If you're going to get Goldobin up, play him in the top six, because this is a player that thrives off of the offense. Play him with Petey. That would honestly give him the best chance of succeeding, because when you call these players up, you're not looking to necessarily fill a hole that Josh Leivo left. You're trying to see if they can exemplify everything and they can expand on what they have a little bit more. So if Goldobin comes up, which I don't know if he will, but if he does, I want him on the top six. Same with Reid Boucher. The guy is kind of slow and the guy's work ethic isn't amazing in his own end, but the guy possesses arguably the best shot in the AHL, and if you have an opportunity to use that, I don't care if the guy can't backcheck, use the guy's shot. Use the guy's shot and get us some more goals, because Reid Boucher has been a pure example of just an offensive one-trick pony. That's all he's able to do at the NHL level at an effective rate, and if he does get the chance to get called up, then I want to see the Canucks exploit that. Get a few more goals here and there and use Boucher and his shot. With Sven Baertschi, it's a little bit different, because Baertschi was in the circumstance where he was a legitimate NHL forward for a while, and he was really good for a while. It's just the looming idea of a concussion does surround this player, and that in itself is a dangerous little thing. But if Sven Baertschi does get called back up, play him with Bo again. Play him with the BBB line. Revitalize that line with Bo and Brock. I want to see that. I want to see Sven Baertschi back in this top six doing his thing, because we know that Travis Green didn't initially want to use Baertschi in the bottom six, which is why he was sent down to Utica in the first place. That's why he was there and why Loui Eriksson was stayed with the team. Nowadays, Loui Eriksson is technically on the roster, he's still playing in there, but Leivo getting injured opens up the door to many opportunities of different lineups. Tonight, against the Penguins, we'll probably see Eriksson. I'm not too sure if I'll be able to catch that game, but later on we will see what happens, and Loui Eriksson, I don't see him playing for 2 to 3 straight months. As for Josh Leivo though, the guy is an absolute workhorse, and that was a terrible, terrible injury. Don't want to see anything like that happen to the future Canucks, because, yo, 2 to 3 months of not playing? That sucks. Holden's hit was bad, but I didn't think it would be that bad. And I guess to end off this video, we should just talk about, hey, just don't talk to Holden online. Don't harass the guy. Seriously, that's a big, big no-no here around these parts. Some people do that, and those people are not the proper Canucks fans that I would like to associate with. So, yeah, just comment down in the comments what you think about the Holden hit, about Leivo in general, and about who should come in and replace him. Because as I said, Eriksson is not going to be that guy. You can mark my words right here. Is it Boucher? Is it Goldobin? Is it Baertschi? Is it another guy that we don't expect? Is it Cole Lind? Because that's a really interesting one too that some people have been bringing up. But all in all, I hope you enjoyed this video. So I'm Cyanine. And bye.